This quick start tutorial will guide you through the main sections of QuBAS and briefly demonstrate the key processes required to set up and analyze a relative potency assay. The example used will be a 4PL model from a 96-well plate with one reference, two test samples and a QC sample. This diagram shows the main components of QuBAS. The system is divided into two parts, Explore and Routine, which are also licensed separately. There are some components that are common to both parts, such as the file import functions, system administration, method management, and audit records. QuBAS uses the term method to describe a collection of files, templates, data maps, analysis definitions, and system and sample suitability criteria required for a particular biological assay. Note that a user can only work on one method at a time, and a method can only be worked on by one user at a time. Quantix uses a concurrent user licensing system split into two parts, Explore users and Routine users. In this installation, there are 10 Explore licenses available and 5 Routine licenses, meaning that 10 users can be logged in concurrently in the Explore mode and 5 in the Routine mode. Audit and admin functions do not require licenses. To get started, select which mode you wish to use, then enter your login details as set up when you responded to the invitation email. Method management. In this section, the method is given a name, and placeholders for information about the data in an imported data file are created. This type of information is called metadata in QuBAS, to distinguish it from the actual experimental data values. Having logged in Explore mode, the next step is to select the method you wish to work on or create a new one. If you wish to work on a current method, select it from the list. The display on the right-hand side will show whether it is available to use, i.e. whether anybody else is using it, who wrote it initially, and whether it has been authorized for routine use. I will go on to demonstrate creating a new method. Click Create New Method. Give the method a name and select the type, either quantile or quantitative. The next step is to define the metadata placeholders for the method. Metadata is any information associated with the method, but not including the response values or doses. Metadata can be of two types: substance metadata, such as the labels that are used to identify the substances on the plate, for example, reference ID, quality control ID, sample ID, and so on. Method metadata is all the other information that may be of interest. Examples might be assay ID, date, operator ID, cell passage number, and so on. You can create as many of these as you wish, and they can be used in search functions within QuBAS and in later functionality for trending. Note, it is best to create as many metadata placeholders as you are likely to need at this stage. They do not all have to be used, but adding, for example, an extra QC sample later in development is more difficult if the placeholder does not already exist. Metadata placeholders that have already been set up in QuBAS can be pulled into this new method. Let's add two test IDs, a reference ID, and a QC ID. Now let's add the assay number as an extra method metadata. This will be of type text. You can also choose whether method metadata is required or optional. Let's make this required. When you have added all the metadata placeholders you wish, click Save. Having created the new method, the next step is to import a data file. Go to the import room, and you can either click on import file and browse to it, or simply drag and drop the file. The file has been imported. The next step is to create a template so that QuBAS knows how to read this file. Click on Templates, New Template, and then, because it is easier to create a template when you have something to create it with, add that data file as a sample. Here you can see the area of the response values and some metadata. The first thing to do is to mask out all of the areas of the data file that are not response values. Click on Skips and mask the rows and columns not required. The next step is to put the blue box around the data values and finally, we can assign the metadata placeholders to the data in the file. Note that this data file does not contain a plate reader ID, so that this information will be collected by manual input when the data file is set to the template. When you're finished, click Confirm. This data file template can be used with any data file that has the same structure. If, during your development, the data file structure changes, then a new template can be created in just the same way. We now have a data file and a data file template, and we need to associate them one with the other. Go back to the data files. Select the data file and set the template. Select the template you wish to use. There's only one available in this demo. Click Next. You will see the template that we have just created laid over the data file. As we noted previously, plate reader information was not included in the data file and therefore has to be put in manually. When all the metadata is complete, click Set Template. The file has been modified. The next step is to create the data map. This is the information that tells QuBAS which of the response values are reference, sample, QC, and so on. Move to the Explore room. And check that the default data map is the right size. You will see on the right-hand side the metadata placeholders that we created when we set up the method. To place these onto the data map, click on the round circle at the top and drag to the correct place. Click on the square to allocate the type, and repeat for the other placeholders. Now we need to add the dosage. Doses can be added either by manually entering them on the right-hand side or by using the magic wand. Doses can be added additive or multiplicative. Select the start dose and the step. Then simply drag. Note that doses do not have to be the same. Nor do samples have to be in straight lines. When you have finished, you can add the units. QuBAS assumes same units throughout. And click complete version. Make a note. Note that you are not restricted to placing the test and reference samples or any other samples on the data map in straight lines. Here is an example of a data map that uses a Latin square coding. The data map can be edited and changed at any time, and the changes can be recorded in a version control. When you click Save, that saves the current data map that is on the screen to be the working copy. If you then click Complete Version, it will save that copy into the version control system. Clicking History shows you the version controls. In this situation, here is the original. Here is a data map where I have deleted some cells and put in one or two strange doses. Here is a data map where I've removed test sample 2 altogether. And this is the current working copy. If I wish to go back to the original, click on the original, click Save, and the working copy changes to the original. Now the system is ready to analyze the data. A number of analysis options are available, together with a wide selection of system and sample suitability criteria. The impact of the various options can be explored, interesting results and the associated analysis settings can be saved to an interactive development record, and reports can be printed or exported. When the development process is complete, the entire method can be locked down and approved for routine or regulatory use. In routine mode, no options are available, and the process becomes simply one of importing a data file, running the pre-authorized and locked analysis, complete with all the system and sample suitability criteria, and then downloading the resultant GXP and 21 CFR Part 11 compliant PDF report. We are now ready to conduct the analysis. Move to the analysis definition screen and select the model you wish to use. The analysis definition screen runs from left to right. First selecting the type of model, then analysis options, which change with the type of model, then system suitability criteria, of which there are many different types, and sample suitability criteria. Initially, we will just have a look at the analysis with simple dose response significance and goodness of fit. Select the data file, and you can see the metadata that has been entered from the file here. Clicking on these will show a simple data plot. The parameters takes you back to this screen, and we could change the various analysis options and see the impact on the raw data. In this case, a log transform for the response looks best. When you have selected everything that you wish, click Analyze. The data will be sent to the analysis engine, and the center screen shows you the progress. If you look closely, you will note that there are two branches, A and B, both operating, and these are the branches of the diverse self-checking pair process. Depending on the complexity of the fit and the parameters of the system suitability criteria, analysis may take a few minutes. When complete, the screen will show the basic plots. This is the reference, test sample 1, test sample 2. The graphs can be zoomed and moved. Individual points can be highlighted, and a grid will show you where they are on the data map. The report can be downloaded. If this analysis is one that you would like to keep for future reference, it can be saved. And also committed to the development report. Doing so allows you to go back to it at a future time. When you have completed the development process and fixed values for all of the analysis parameters and system and sample suitability criteria if required, the analysis can be locked down for routine or regulatory use. To do this, run a final analysis on a data set and save it and commit it to the development record. Go to the development record and click Submit as MCF, which stands for Method Configuration File. This will submit the method for sign-off by an authorized user. Method sign-off is achieved in the routine mode, so log out, select a routine mode license and log back in. Select the method, and you will now see that the sign-off run is available if you have appropriate authorization, and here is the method ready to be signed off. Select it, approve, and sign it off. It now becomes method configuration file version 1 and is locked down. To use the new analysis in routine mode, sign in with a routine mode license. Select the method. You can see that it has a little star next to it, which shows that it is a signed off method. And there's the message. And you will now see that the only options available to you are import and routine. Go to the import room, import a file in the same way, and then go to the routine room, select new run, select the files that you have uploaded. Note, you can upload more than one at a time. Here is the file information as before, and the plate reader ID. You will recall this has to be entered manually. Give the run a name, and then go to the routine room. Select whether you wish electronic signatures, select metadata that you may want on it, and start the run. The analysis will now be run as if you are in explore mode. Once completed, the report can be downloaded, and this report, because it has been run in the routine mode, will have data that you may want on it, an electronic signature, and the full audit trail, which includes all of the details of the files used, all of the validation and diverse self-checking pair programming processes, and a final authorization that this is valid for use.